Hello student, student, in last video we have discussed about the application of dimensions and we have discussed many numericals which are based on the application of dimension. So student, now it's time for a new topic and the name of the new topic is significant figures. Okay, so student, we will understand this topic by giving one examples. I am taking one example. Hope you will understand every concept behind this. Okay, so students, suppose I measure a length and after the measurement it is 14.5 centimeter. Okay, I have measured one length and by using meter scale and the value of measurement is 14.5 meter. So student, what these digits are indicating, or what this value is indicating? It is indicating that we have done measurement up to 1 upon 10th part of a centimeter. Okay, because this is 0.5. So it means we have measured the value up to 1 upon 10th of a centimeter. And what it is indicating? In this value 1 and 4, these 1 and 4 are absolute correct. Absolutely correct, whereas 5 is reasonably correct. What it is reasonably correct. So what is the meaning of this absolutely correct and reasonably correct? Student, suppose this is the length. I said this is the 14.5 centimeter. So it means 14 is the accurate value. Now come to the 0.5. Student, maybe this length can be 0.501 or 0.5001. It is not sure whether it is exact or not. Okay, whether it is exact value or maybe it is simply 0.51. Maybe. Okay, so student, that's why I have written here it is the reasonably correct value, or you can say this value is the approximate value. What? Approximate value. Okay, again 1.4 is the true value or absolutely correct value, whereas this 5 is the reasonably correct value or approximate value. Okay, one more example. Suppose I have measured a length and that is 14.52. Now what it is indicating? Now it is indicating that we have done our measurement up to 1 upon 100th part of, written here, what? We have done our measurement up to 1 upon 100th of a centimeter. Okay, as it is clear, because after decimal we have two digits, so it is up to 1 upon 100th part of a centimeter. And now we have 1.45 as the 1.45 as the absolutely correct value, correct number. These 1.45 are absolute correct number, where 2 is the reasonable correct, or you can say 2 is the approximate value, because maybe this value is 4.5201 or 0001. Okay, so what we generally we leave these numbers, because there will be no effect when we will leave these numbers. So we generally write 14.52 centimeter. Okay, So now on the basis of these two examples, we will state the definitions of significant figure. So what is the definition of significant figure? These are the numbers in value of physical quantity which are made up of certain value plus, these are the certain value, absolutely correct value is called certain value. What? Certain, because these are correct. If anything is called correct, it means that is certain. Plus one more digit, you write here certain, where in place of certain value you write certain digits plus make a sign, or you write plus plus one more digit that is called uncertain digit. Okay, so what is the significant figure? Significant figure of any physical quantity or in any number is what? Combination of certain number plus uncertain number. So what is the significant figure in 14.5? The significant figure in 14.5 is 3. What? 3. Because 1, 2 and this one is 3. So significant figure for 14.5 equal to 3. Similarly, in 14.52, what will be the significant figure? Because 14.5, these are the certain value and 2 is the uncertain value. I have told you in significant figure is the combination of certain digit plus uncertain digit. So certain digit is 3 plus 1, 4. So significant figure for this is 4. So 4 is the significant figure for 14.52 and the 3 is the significant for, so 3 is the significant figure for the 14.5. okay, so student, there are some rules to write the significant figure of any numerical value. So so student, first one is the, if we have all non-zero number, so what is all non-zero numbers are counted in significant figure. How? Means if we have number 14, this is the non-zero, 5, 6, 3, all non-zero number, it may be any number which is non-zero, all will be counted in significant figure. So what will be its significant figure? Its significant figure will be 2. It is a 563, what will be its significant figure? 3, 1, 9, 6, 3, 7, I am writing randomly, okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Significant figure will be 5. So all the non-zero number are counted in significant figure. Second one, All the zeros in between non-zero number are counted in significant figure. What? All zero in non-zero number counted in significant figure. Very simple rules. There are 4-5 rules. So you have to learn these. Suppose I have a number 5001. So we will count all these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So significant figure will be 5. This is the significant figure. If I write 501, so its significant figure will be 3. If I write 5001, its significant number will be 4. So all the zeros which are written in between non-zero. This is the 0 I have written in between non-zero. This is 0 I have written in between non-zero. So all the zeros which are written in between the non-zero number, that are called significant figure. Okay, this is the rule number second. Now come to the rule number third. Any zero before and after decimal. Any zero before and after decimal not counted in significant figure. If we have zero before and after the decimal, suppose this is the decimal point and we write here 0 and we write here 0, then 5. So we will not count these 0. So in significant figure, so what will be its significant figure? 1. If I write 0.00016, so what will be its significant figure? 2. If I write here 0.00502, now what will be its significant figure? 3, because we will count the 0 in between 2 non-zero digit, but we will not count the 0 directly before and after the decimal point. Rule is this. So this is the very important. I have written here 0 in between 2 non-zero digit, so this 0 will be counted. Okay, I hope you are understanding what I want to say. It's very easy. If there is any zero before a decimal and after the decimal, okay, we will not count. If any zero in between two non-zero digit, these are two non-zero digit, okay, so we will count that zero. This is the rule number third. I think this one is third. Now student, coming to the rule number fourth. Student, if there is any zero at the last of any number, so we will not count that zero. Any zero at last of non-zero digit will not counted. How? If I write 5510, so we will not count this zero. So what will be its significant figure? 3. If I write 5010, now what will be its significant figure? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4. Because we will not count the zero which is at last. Because we will count the zero only that case when there will be before and after non-zero number. Like this. Before this zero we have non-zero number, after this zero we have non-zero number. So we will count the zero in significant number only in that case when there is non-zero number before and after the before and after the zero. Okay, we will not count the zero which is at the last of digit. I think you got my point. If I write 5, 5, 6, 0, 0, 0, so what will be its significant figure? What will be its significant figure? 3. Okay. Now coming to your last rule to find out the zeros of any this is the if zero comes at last in decimal expansion, in decimal, like if zero comes at last of decimal, it will be counted. Beta, you have to remember all point, don't be confused. जीरो कहाँ पर, अगर होल नंबर है उसके लास्ट में जीरो है वो आपको काउंट नहीं करना है. जीरो दोनों नॉन डिजिट के नंबर में है उसको आप काउंट करेंगे. जीरो अगर आप डेसिमल के पहले और बाद में है उसे आप काउंट नहीं करेंगे. लेकिन अगर डेसिमल नंबर है और लास्ट में जीरो लगा है यू विल काउंट. हाउ विल बी काउंटेड, इफ आई राइट हियर 0.560 लाइक दिस. देखो देयर इज डिफरेंस बिटवीन 0.0560. दीज इन दिस केस दीज जीरो विल नॉट बी काउंट, बट इन दिस केस बिकॉज दिस इज द लास्ट ऑफ एट द एंड ऑफ दिस डेसिमल डिजिट सो इट विल बी काउंटेड. सो सिग्निफिकेंट फिगर विल बी 3 एंड इट्स सिग्निफिकेंट फिगर विल ऑल्सो बी 3 बिकॉज वी विल नॉट काउंट दीज टू. सो दिस विल बी 3. इफ आई राइटिंग हियर 0.10000 so what will be its significant figure, it will be counted 1 2 3 4, its significant figure will be 4. Okay, so I hope you understood what I want to say. These all are the five or six point to find out the significant digit of any number. So student, one more thing to remember, never forget, and this is the student, if I write 1453 meter, okay, if I write 1453 meter and another student write it into 10^2 centimeter, in both these both quantities are same, so what will be the significant figure in these two cases? Here significant figure will be what? Significant figure will be 4. In this case significant figure will also be 4. Significant figure will not be changed. So this is the this is from my side. So I hope you all got all the points. If still any problem, don't be confused in calling me. You just call me or you can send me the message. So thank you, have a nice day.